Richard. He's 39.
It was a beautiful performance. The Ageless Wonder, back in the day, I promoted the alien, Bernard Hopkins. I think we have a new alien here in the sport. He's redefining that age really is only a number. Absolutely thrilling performance, and much more to come from the Filipino Flash. Happy to be here now. Pretty much right after the fight, I caught the plane here in Dubai now. So this is like one big boxing convention.
I see Josh Taylor, everybody. I see Terrence Crawford, Usyk.
Everybody is here, everybody is here. There are promoters, managers, fighters, advisors, there's Maravillo Martinez there. There's like,
I see Arthur Abraham, right?
Everybody is here. This is like a global event, and that's what sport, that's what boxing is, global event. And I'm happy to be here and presenting Pro Bello.
You have a lot of big fighters. You signed Regis Progress.
Yes, he's here as well. Regis is here as well. So just absolutely fantastic.
Estaniones, he's supposed to be in line to fight Ugas for the 147 title.
So, looks like we're going to have a new welterweight champion there, so we're excited about that. Great young talent. He worked hard. He was waiting for this opportunity, and now it's here. So just, you know, I mean, this is what the sport is. You build up young fighters, and you try to help them to fulfill their dreams to become world champion. That's what Pro Bello really is about, whether we're working with a young fighter like an Estanionis, who we turn pro, or whether we are working with one of the true legends of the sport, like a Nonito Donaire. It doesn't really matter, as long as it is helping the fighters to fulfill their dreams.
Now, Richard, you have a special relationship with Canelo Alvarez. What do you think about him moving up from 68 to cruiserweight?
Well, I'm not surprised. When I spoke with him last, I was telling him, I said, you know, the way you're going, that was before he announced he's going to go to cruiserweight, the way you keep challenging yourself, I wouldn't be surprised if one day you're going to be fighting for the heavyweight championship of the world. And I was kidding, but I actually, the way he looked at me, I knew that he was seriously thinking about it. So I wouldn't rule it out that we are going to see him eventually fight for the heavyweight championship. He got balls. He keeps challenging himself. He fights the best. That's why he is today, pound for pound, the best fighter in the world.
Roy Jones did it. James Toney did it, and I think Canelo will do it.
It's just absolutely amazing, and I wish him all the best. What an asset to the sport. What a great ambassador we have with him. First-class guy, a good friend, and I wish him nothing but the best.
Richard, 135 division is boiling hot. Who do you think is leading the pack right now?
Well, I have to say, Gervonta, I mean, it's just like, really, there's so much talent there now. I think Gervonta Davis really is the total package. He can fight. But, you know, this is, you have to admit, to go and sell out Staples Center in Los Angeles, that was a statement. And so he really is a star. But then, of course, you have Haney as well, and you have Teofimo still, and you have Cambosas now, and you have, I mean, there's so many.
There's Loma, it's a cruise line,
well,
yep.
You know, so there's so much going on. And the good news is, I don't really care. If you put all those names in a hat, I'm talking as a fight fan now, you put all these names in a hat and you pick two, there's no bad matchups. No matter what name you pick, great matchups. Fights, I'd like to see as a fan.
Last one. If your fighter wins a 47 and he beats Ugas and becomes champ, if Estaniones beats Ugas,
yes.
Do you want Spence or do you want Crawford? Because they have the other belts.
It doesn't matter. I mean, that's
either
the, that's
or.
The kind, that's the refreshing thing with Nonito Donaire. He wants to fight anyone. He believes in himself. I believe in him. You know, that's the beauty of the sport. When you see young fighters go up and keep challenging themselves and are not afraid of the risks. And you know what? Sometimes when you reach for the stars, you actually get them, and sometimes you don't, you know. As long as they keep challenging themselves. And that's a refreshing thing with many of those young fighters, and we just mentioned before some of them as well.
There you have it, Richard. Where do people follow Parabellum on social media?
Yes, on the Parabellum, the Twitter, and Richard_Schaefer Sports. Schaefer_Sports on my Instagram. And lots of news coming out. Great here. I think there are going to be some great news coming out here as well with the comeback coin. So very, very exciting times indeed. And happy to have you here reporting live.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Thank you so much, Richard.